Factoring trinomials. How do we factor a trinomial? In this video, I will give you guys 6 examples of my favorite technique of factoring a trinomial, and that's called the tic-tac-toe method. So have a look right here. For the first one, we have x squared plus 10x plus 16. Well, we are going to first start by drawing the tic-tac-toe board like this. And then we are just going to ask ourselves, what times 4 give us x squared? Well, we can just use x and x. Good. And then we come here and we ask ourselves, what times 4 give us 16? Well, we have a couple choices, right? 1 times 16, or 2 times 8, or maybe 4 times 4, and maybe negative 4 times negative 4, right? Things like that. But the correct combination that we're going to use is 2 and 8. Why? Because you see, this is how we do it to check. You do 8 times x, and you get 8x. You do this times that, which is 2x. Together, 8x plus 2x, we do get a 10x. So this is the correct combination. And when you write down the answer, be sure you go across. So the answer for this is x plus 2 times x plus 8. And then we are done, just like that. All right, next one. Well, notice that we have 5, 10, and 5, so we can factor out 5 first. Let's go ahead and do that before we do the tic-tac-toe, and we'll get 5 times x squared, and then plus, this is 2. I mean, originally it was 10, divided by 5, we'll get 2. And then we'll have the plus 1, right? 5 divided by 5 is 1. And do the tic-tac-toe here. So go ahead, do the tic-tac-toe. All right, x times x gives us x squared, and 1 times 4 gives us 1. And you see, x times 1 is x, and then 1 times x is x. Together, we do get the 2x. Good. So here is the answer. 5 all the way in the front, and then x plus 1 times another x plus 1. So let's just write yes, x plus 1 to the second power, and then we are done. Next one. Okay, tic-tac-toe box in action. X times x gives us the x squared, and then to get negative 15, let's use 5 and 3, but one of them has to be negative, right? Let's put on 5 and negative 3. Does this work? Let's go ahead and do this to check. X times negative 3 gives us negative 3x. 5 times x gives us 5x. Together, we do end up with the 2x. So again, this checks. So we have x plus 5, and then the other one is x minus 3. Done. Now, for D, unfortunately, we cannot factor any common factor, but it's okay, let's just go ahead and do the tic-tac-toe. And by the way, all these examples are factorable, so just keep that in mind. Okay, there are, again, a couple ways to break this down, right? We can do 1x times 6x, or maybe 2x and 3x. And the trouble for the negative 10 is we can also break it down as 1 times negative 10, 2 times negative 5, or maybe the negative go the other way. Well, it doesn't matter which method that you're using. There is always going to be some kind of guess and check being involved. If it doesn't work out the first time, just go ahead and try another combination. I'm going to do it with a wrong combination first, on purpose. Let's try if we have 2x times 3x. Okay, to get negative 10, maybe we use 5 and 2. Maybe I just do 5 and 2, and we have to make one of them negative, right? So maybe let's make this negative, and let's see what happens. 2x times negative 2 gives us negative 4x. 5 times 15x, sorry, that's the answer. 5 times 3x is 15x, but together, 15x minus 4x, it's not 7x. This is the wrong combination. Now, check this out. We are actually going to do the following. Let's go ahead and put down x times 6x. That will give us 6x squared. And now, to get negative 10, we are going to use 5 and 2, but one of them should be negative, right? Well, I'm not going to put down 5 here, because 5 times 6x will be 30x. That will be too big from the positive 7x. What we'll do is put down 2 here and then 5 here, and you see 2 times 6x is 12x. And then that will give us 5x here. Well, if we make this negative, then we will have x times this, which is negative 5x, and then this times that will give us 12x, and then you see this and that together, we do get the positive 7x. So the answer for this is x plus 2 times 6x minus 5. And this right here becomes harder because we have a coefficient in front of dx squared that's not 1. So you will have like a couple choices for that. So the order of this matter and the order of this also matter. But in the end, the order of how to write down the factors doesn't matter. Now let's look at this one. Unfortunately, we cannot factor out a common number. So let's just go ahead and proceed with the tic-tac-toe. Okay, this right here is not bad, x times 3x. Well, you can write it as 3x times x, doesn't really matter. Now, this is the part that really matters the most. What times 4 give us negative 40? And let's see, maybe use 5 and 8, and one of them should be negative. So let's go ahead and put that down. Okay, if we do that, that will give us 8x, and this is going to give me 15x. I don't think that's going to work out. Like, there's no way for us to get a negative 19x, regardless which one I make negative, so no. Maybe let me just reverse the order. Let's put down 8 and 5. And then you see, this times this will give us 5x. This times this will give us 24x. Well, which one should be negative now? This one. Because this way, 3x times negative 8 will give us negative 24. Together will give us negative 19x. So the answer is x minus 8 times 3x plus 5. Good. Now, for the last one. Again, cannot factor any common factor. Just go ahead and proceed. Okay, for the 2x squared, let's put down 2x and x. Again, the order right here doesn't matter. Let's attack this one. Maybe 4 and 7. And because right here it's negative, the 4 and 7 should both be negative. And let's put down negative 4 here and negative 7 here. Does it work? Of course. You see, this times this gives us negative 8x. This times that gives us negative 7x. Negative 15x. Done. So the answer is 2x minus 7 times x minus 4. Alright, so hopefully this video helps. If you guys need more help with algebra, you guys can check out my other video and subscribe to my channel for future videos. That's it.